This is an important area, and everyone has a strong sense of their own worth and their own value. And this is informed in part by internal relativity. That is how people feel that they relate within their own organisation to the people they regard as their peers. And there needs to be a sense of fairness there. Externally, people are relating to what they perceive as the market rate for the work that they're doing. And that may be informed by their own experience through recruitment or their previous working experience. Now, that sense of value contributes to somebody's motivation, and it comprises a number of factors in terms of reward. Firstly, salary. There may also be bonuses and incentives, but also the benefits which you're able to provide, and of course the status within the organisation as well. It's important to get those right, both in terms of attracting the right sort and quality of people that you need for your business, but also for retaining them. Well, when you're looking at pay levels, you really need to keep three factors in mind. The first of these is position. That is, how does the pay actually match up to the market rate? And the best way to find this out is through some sort of market benchmarking. And there's a lot of information and a lot of surveys which are available for different sectors to give you an idea of rates. In addition to that, of course, you can look at advertisements and contact recruitment agencies who will be able to give you an indication of what the appropriate rate is. Usually, you'll find that the published rates are an average, or more precisely, a median. And of course, you can choose to pay where you feel is appropriate to attract the right people and in order to retain them. The second point to bear in mind is around progression. That is how somebody's value will be growing as they work within your business. And you can choose to structure your pay system so that people perhaps stay on a spot salary, which then changes periodically through market benchmarking, or you can put people into a salary range where they may progress in terms of pay increases through experience and demonstration of their competence in the role. Finally, the third point to bear in mind in reviewing pay is people's performance. And some sort of review process is important there. Of course, it doesn't have to be appraisal, but you need to know how people are performing against expectation. And you can choose to reward them in a number of different ways for that. Well, there are a number of ways of linking pay to performance. Perhaps some of the best known are bonus schemes, merit awards, share options, and performance-related pay. Whichever approach you go for, you must be absolutely clear about what you are expecting from people in terms of performance. And it's worthwhile spending time early on in the design of your pay system to be absolutely clear that those links to performance will work. You also need to be clear that you are looking at somebody's overall contribution to your business. So whilst there might be quantitative targets that you set, whether that's in terms of finance or production or sales, you also need to be very clear about how you expect people to behave and to contribute effectively to your business. Now, sometimes that is going to be a matter of defined performance standards, but that's a fairly formal way of going about it. The most effective way is the role model that you and the other senior people within the business can provide for your staff and more junior managers. Clearly, we're in tough economic times, and we're all aware of pay freezes in parts of the private sector over the last couple of years, and certainly in the public sector now. Any pay award, of course, is going to be dependent upon affordability. And many businesses that we're working with are looking at a variety of approaches to this. Current pay data shows that pay awards in the private sector are running at about 2% this year. So that gives you an indication of the sort of awards which people might be expecting. And a number of our clients are aiming their pay awards at about that level. There are, of course, options for providing non-consolidated payments, and particularly if you are wanting to target pay increases at high performers when affordability is going to be a key issue.